Hey guys, we're out back out here disking. It's field down. And cool, deletes the weeds, cool. Why I haven't had any videos up lately is because my computer's been sick, so I won't be able to put any videos out, so I'm out here with the Case World Tractor. We're on a Wind Chaser map. We're out here plowing this field down, so we come with the planter and plant some soybeans out in this field. Screw it. Let course play do this. And we can get on and going bigger and badder stuff, so. Generate course. There we go. I'll just take my Jeep. But I gotta show you guys something too that I did. Took me a while to figure it out, but I got it to work. At the chicken coops here. Now if I go here. Animals, chickens. See, I moved the chickens navigation mesh and brought them over here. This is like my little regular house / chicken farm. What I think it's cool about these chicken coops, you walk up, door opens, you can climb that. I thought it was pretty cool. You move out, door opens and shuts. And I downloaded this big red barn. So I think it was pretty cool. And I'll show you guys something else too. Let me whip a Yui. I got a float tree, I have to fix that. That one's floating too, I'll have to fix that. I just been messing around editing this map. Just having fun with it, editing and seeing if stuff works. It's what I've been doing for the past couple weeks. So now we're at the dairy farm. Got the trees. I got a 6-car garage connected to the house. I got grain bins here. Got the cow barn here. Drive inside. Everybody should know what the barn looks like, so I'll just fly through here. And what's cool over here, I got my feeding trough here. And if I go there, got animals. I'll buy some cows here real quick. So you guys can see I moved the cows over to this farm. Better than your regular other dairy farm. We got that plane that flies over. I gotta fix that. It's floating. Gotta fix the fence. Gotta fix to get this. Anybody knows how to get this manure thing to work? That'd be great. Yeah, I'm fencing in this pasture here, so we're gonna have cows out here in the pasture out here too. It's all a work in progress still. That cow's in the slurry tank, whatever. Well, I thought that was pretty cool. I can move the animals to a different location. So that's that. I just started this map, so from editing, got the case 235 at the case 235, the row crops. Now we got this old timer baler. That's just about it. I got some trucks too. Yeah, I know it's got the gasser sound. I gotta switch it to the diesel sound, but this is actually one of my first mod I ever did. So I'm pretty happy with it. But at 75 subscribers, this truck will be released. It's got the Rockstar rims and Confederate flag Cummins logo on the back. So let's keep that in mind. At 75 subs, this will be released. And you can see I paved the road, so I didn't have that ugly wind chaser road. No tractor supply. Still gotta cultivate and do that field still too. Got grass field over here. National beef. Anybody knows how to put beef into a map, I would appreciate it. I'm the town I still gotta work on still. You see, we got the light right there. That would be fixed. Yeah, he's still trucking right along. Cool, I might go get our other 235. Roll crap, I'll go out and help him. Well, tell me what you guys think of the graphics. Because I did some tweaking with the computer too, so. And I added a different sky to the map. I took the stupid soil mod out. I can't stand that mod. I hate that mod with a passion. Like driving that. Alright. Go buy another one. And I have to say thanks to Jake Lenz for letting me know about this pack they have here. This is all in one pack, all these cases. This one, all these. Including the wheels. And then they include New Hollands too, so you get a big massive pack. What I like about this tractor, you can move the wheels in and out. So I always thought it was pretty cool. Space. Here, put my warning lights out. I feel like doing this at night time. Kinda at night. Put my warning lights out. My beacon lights. And let's go to town. That's a big dip. Hey guys, just let me know about what you guys think of the graphics. Or I might start on that other field by my farm. This field, hit, a course play is on. I just gotta go in soybeans. The one that I'm probably gonna go and do, it's probably gonna be in, probably put that in corn. Yeah, it's one thing I kind of hate about the case tractors at night. You barely can see anything. Make it early morning. Got the fog, morning fog. I couldn't do it at night because you can't see nothing. That's why I like the John Deere's, because they have that work light you can put on and it makes it a lot brighter. And you can see from it for a far distance. So with this down this field, probably do the headland on this, and then we'll send this to course play. and American Truck Simulator. That game, I finally figured out how to play multiplayer with other people. Last night, I just tested it out and gave it a try. And there was about 400 and something people online. It was just like crazy. I was watching some YouTube videos on it, and one time this one guy was, I don't know his name or anything, but he was playing the American Truck Simulator on multiplayer, and there's like 4,000 or 5,000 trucks out there. It was nuts. Even to get gas at a gas station in that game, you had to wait and like, and just, it was like a big back, it's like a big backup. Even the rest areas, parking spots were jam-packed with trucks. So I guess you just gotta hit it at the right time, where a lot of people are playing. Turn off my beacon. I just have my running lights on. Now what's cool about this tractor? The gear stick moves. I don't think I've ever seen a Chase Magnum in this game that they had the working gear stick. I could try that GPS mod, but I'm not really familiar with it. Maybe I'll mess with it later on tonight and figure it out. Getting ready for that sun to come up. That's why I put that sun visor down. Yeah, we'll do another headland instead of pulling the plow back up. We're out here doing some spring tillage so we can get our crops in. I know I'm probably going to have to go over what the guy on course play missed, because they always miss. They're never always perfect. Neither they miss a little, or they just totally mess up. Yeah, me and my family, we went out to Valdosta, Georgia, and we saw a drone that was at Best Buy for $500. I don't know if that's a good price for, I think it was called like the Phantom 3. I don't know if that's a good price or, so I'm not really don't know drones that much. But it's actually my first time actually seeing a drone, and those things are pretty sweet. there goes that plane. Taking off. It's gonna fly right over us now. There he is. Would this tractor pull that plow behind us? Well, actually, in real terms, it's called a disc, but it pulls it pretty nice. It's kind of eerie about this tractor, but it plows it pretty nice. At 10.6 miles an hour, I think it's pulling it pretty good. As you can see on our map, the CP on our map is course play. He's still trucking right along. This big hill, slowing down to 8, 7, 6, 5. We pull this disc up this hill at 5.8 miles an hour. That's pretty good. And if you're wondering what software I use to record my videos, it's OBS software. It's a free download from the internet. And hopefully in June, I'll take a trip up to Wisconsin, where I used to live, and visit some old friends. That'd be kind of cool. But those, if I take video of that, that would be on my other YouTube channel. This channel is just typically gaming. Anything that's a game that I can record, it'll go to this channel. My other YouTube channel is called Marcus Hicks, HICKSMARKUS, Marcus Hicks. Go like that channel. I might put that channel in the description of this video. You guys can check that out. Basically, it's like car related, road trips, anything has to do with like automotive or cars or any of that. Because I got Tifton truck pulls. I really didn't get any much video on that because my GoPro is full. But there's some pretty cool videos I might post up on my other Facebook since it's automotive. And it's not gaming, so it'll go to that channel, not this one. And I'm going to check out my other YouTube channel because I got the NASCAR haulers rolling into Atlanta Motor Speedway parade, if you guys would like to check that out. in June, I'll be taking some video of the Orphaville, Wisconsin June Day's truck pulls. That's in the future still. That's all the way in June. Still got a couple months for that. Then hopefully I can visit my buddy Jake Lins. He's got a YouTube channel. You guys go check out his stuff. I might put his YouTube channel in the description. Go check out his. He has a pretty sweet case. And he does vlogs. He does all that. And he farms in real life. He's a pretty cool guy. Hey guys, go check out his channel. He's pretty cool. He's also a farmer in Wisconsin too. It's weird because I live down here in southern Georgia, and everybody I really talk to that are modders or at least played a farming game or American Truck Simulator are basically all from Wisconsin. It's just weird. It's like when I lived up there, I knew a lot of people, but never was just played this farming game for the heck of it, and didn't know how to do anything, and didn't know half what their equipment did and all that, and started watching videos and getting really to know agriculture and all tractors and everything. Basically all started from this game. And then I went to these mod sites over Facebook and started talking to some people, and I started watching some YouTube videos, and the first person I ever watched was Ryan from How Farms Work. His channel is amazing. Yeah, I learned a lot from his channel. Mostly I learned everything basically from his channel. How Farms Work is an amazing channel. You guys could go check that out. Ryan is amazing. And then I started watching some more farm simulator videos and ran across Jake. And me and him's been talking since day one I checked out his channel. I helped him put his auger out on his combine, and he says he loves it, so that's pretty cool. That's how I got all these sweet mods, and I was watching some other people's videos, and I learned how to texture buildings, and learned how to put wheels on tractors, or not tractors, but wheels on trucks, and how to repaint, change colors of trucks. I learned learn a lot from other people's YouTube channels, and that's how I get to know what I'm doing now. How I learn how to put the animals on to a different location on the map. And that's how I learned how to do Giants Editor and all that too, so. I started with this in Farm Simulator 2013. Just driving tractors and not really knowing what I was doing. But it's 12:18, I give it about another 4 minutes and we'll have to end the video. Cause then I'll have to edit and upload it. And I gotta wait for it to process, go through all those steps on YouTube. We're almost done with this field anyway. There goes the shadow from the plane. I don't know about the sky. I don't know, should I keep it or go put in another sky texture? I don't know. My next video might come out probably next week or whenever I have time, but that might be an American Truck Simulator multiplayer, because playing with all those other people, I think that's pretty cool. Well, guys, thanks for watching. I'm gonna finish up plowing down this field. Please like, subscribe. And remember, 75 subscribers. Big Red Cummins gets version 2 gets released, because I already released version 1. Version 2 will be released at 75 subscribers. And remember, go check out How Farms Works channel, Jake Lynn's channel. And thank you.